There are three categories of startups, I call it, right? The first one is about the copycats, right? These guys are looking at what is trending in US and China. They start copying. In each copycat idea, there could be one winner or maybe zero, because some of these technologies may be advanced. It does not meet the psychology of our customers. So be wary of that trending sector. But unfortunately, the trending sector gets more attention, then more and more entrepreneurs jump into that bandwagon. Because every success story in a trending sector, there are 50, 60 dying. Then the second category is about playing on India's strength, which takes time, but it's visionary. They're solving very serious problems. And as long as you solve a nice problem and you're able to look at the scalability. So I've invested in Carbon Master. It picked up a 100-year-old technology like a biogas. It completely revived bio-CNG and doing really awesome. Saahas, just simple waste management. She's already raised Series A. And Uniphore, which was rejected by 25 investors, but he believed in a vision about speech recognition for 1 billion people. Here is a Chennai-based company competing with Google and Apple and recognized by investor like chairman of Cisco, saying that here is a future, but he was rejected by 25 investors. So what I liked in him is about his ability to stay on the vision. Third category is about disruptive innovation. We don't have anybody in the country today, but there is a great potential as well, because we need a new energy source to the world, which nobody knows what it is. And the way we live in urban cities, it is not sustainable, and it's more and more problems. So where is the future of the city? And everything we look at, roti, kapda, makan, you know, what you eat, what you're wearing, where you're living, need a paradigm shift. I'm looking for inverse entrepreneurs who can come with this crazy ideas, completely stupid right now, so that they can solve this problem, because only you can find out a fantastic solution for this, because MNCs cannot innovate and many of these governments are trying to figure out. But we have a fantastic youth, especially the youth where you had without any baggage, start looking for some crazy ideas to solve, bring disruptive innovation.